start working our way through the categories. We will start with best beer review. And we will have top three winners for each of these, as well as in some cases, honorable mention. And we start with an honorable mention for M. Sauter, in the publication, The Alcohol Professor, for a review of Jolly Pumpkin Artisan Ales, Oro de Calabaza. Congrats to M. Third place in the category goes to Johnny Garrett for 15 Years of Endless Summer, How Thornbridge High Porter Changed British Beer, published on Good Beer Hunting. Second place for Best Beer Review to Martin Cornell. So what happens if you mix the new Guinness 0.0 with Guinness 4 and Extra Stout on Zithophile, his blog? Congrats to Martin. And first place in Best Beer Review goes to Owen Walsh for Zinnebeer, A Beer for Living In, published in Pellicle Magazine. Congrats to all of our winners. We'll go on to our next category for Best Short Form Writing. In this, third place goes to Brandon Kearney for B-roll number 590 on Good Beer Hunting. Congrats, Brandon. Ashley Joanna for The Postman, posted on the Belgian Smock. She gets second place in short form writing. First place in the category goes to Owen Walsh for Thirst, This Must Be the Place, published on Brussels Beer City. Congrats. And then we'll round out our first section of awards today by looking at the best book category. An honorable mention in this goes to Andreas Krenemar for Vienna Lager. Third place goes to Owen Walsh for Brussels Beer City, Stories from Brussels Brewing Past. Second place goes to Paul Kahn. Congrats, Paul, for Hawaii Beer, A History of Brewing in Paradise. And first place in the best book category goes to Tom Assatelli for Pilsner, How the Beer of Kings Changed the World. Congrats to Tom. So I'm going to take a few pauses as we're going through the awards today to highlight some of the things that the Guild has been up to, the way that we can meet and celebrate each other. I want to start with probably one of the most important things that we've done over the last calendar year plus. We started back in July of last year with virtual happy hours. These are not just get-togethers. These are focused kind of educational, networking, learning opportunities where you get a sense and an opportunity to learn from our peers, from industry experts. This is just a range of things that we've published there. We have had 30 videos since the start of this year. This is just a small collection of names with people who we've spent an hour with on evenings to listen, ask them questions, to help sharpen our skills and better understand what's going on in the beer industry and around the world. Avery Swanson, Ren Navarro, Jesse Thorne of NPR fame, perhaps you recognize that name, on the topic of interviewing and how to be a better interviewer. Rob Todd and Jason Perkins, we talked to them about finding inspiration. Of course, they're from Allagash Brewing. Marcus Baskerville about what it means to have created both The Black is Beautiful Beer, as well as interacting with media nonstop over a year. We had guests from the Craft Maltsters Guild and then experts on beer law, how to pitch publications successfully, and a lot more. This has been one of the great highlights of the past year or so, finding opportunities to meet, chat, and improve skills. And I have heard back from many members. They have had either guests on their shows, new sources in stories because of these. Some people have been able to get pitches accepted because of what they've heard or what they've learned, new books being written because of these. And if you want, you can catch up with all of these. We have a running archive on our YouTube page. Just give a search for NAGBW or NAGBW Guild on YouTube, and you will find our page with all of our videos. Okay, we are gonna go on to the next category. We're gonna focus on best historical writing. In third place in the category goes to Tom Assatelli for Grab and Go, How Imperialism Aided the Spread of European Beer, published in Good Beer Hunting. Second place goes to Brian Alberts for Streets as Stages, The Munich Beer Riots of 1844, published in Good Beer Hunting. And first place in best historical writing goes to Mark Dredge for Respect Your Elders, How Fuggle and Golden Hops Changed Modern Beer Forever, also published in Good Beer Hunting. Congrats, Mark and crew. All right, next category is best technical writing. So we jump in. The honorable mention in this category goes to Will Hawks. Congrats, Will, for On the Wagon, the innovations behind non-alcoholic renaissance in British brewing, published in Good Beer Hunting. In third place, Scott Simpson, with New Words for an Old Thing, The Triumph and Blindness of Sensory Science, published in Good Beer Hunting. Second place goes to Jeff Allworth for How a Hop Earns Its Name. Jeff published that on his blog, Beervana. And Jeff also will be receiving first place in the category for The Future of Yeast, also published on his Beervana blog. I will also pause again to remind everybody, we will have a full list of all of these winners, as well as links to all of these stories and books and podcasts on the Reporter's Notebook blog, so you can sort back through and read and catch up on things you might have missed over the course of the past year. So we're going to pause right there again to talk about some of the great things that the Guild has been up to. This has been one of the most important projects that we've had over the last few years, the Diversity in Beer Writing Grant. What is that? So this is an opportunity for writers who may not be fully established as freelance writers to tell stories about diversity and inclusion in beer. We the Guild have partnered with craftbeer.com, where we have these stories published, as well as Allagash Brewing, who helps to support some of the underwriting for these stories. We've had three stories published so far in 2021 by Jen Blair, Jonathan Andrade, and Ashley Rodriguez. You can get a sense right there, and you also will find all of these again on reportersnotebook.org. We've had 10 stories under this grant published since 2018. We first started taking pitches for this grant in 2017, started publishing them in 2018. And this year we've had three stories published so far. We still have one more coming soon from Holly Reagan, which will be published before the end of the year as well. So thanks to everybody for supporting the Guild, which helps us support this grant, which helps us support writers and stories that wouldn't have been able to get told otherwise. So thanks to all of you for reading, writing, and sharing those stories. Thank you too. One of the great things has been getting publications who recognize the value that this grant has had, both featured this past year by Beth Demon and David Judison in stories in which they examine the function of diversity and inclusion in beverage alcohol, as well as beer writing. The grant was featured in both of these pieces. And so I'm very appreciative of everybody who's been a part of these, bringing this grant to life and highlighting it and the way it functions within the beverage alcohol industry. Thank you so much. Okay, we'll get back to awards and we will look at best travel writing. Not surprisingly, a difficult past year to tell these kinds of stories, but I'm thrilled that we still have some great pieces to highlight for the 2021 awards. Honorable mention in this case goes to Claire Bullen for The Land of Fire and Quick, however you want to pronounce it, Farmhouse Brewing at the Crossroads in Voss, Norway, published in Good Beer Hunting. Third place in the travel writing category goes to Holly Reagan for Past Meets Presence, a voyage to Seattle Ballard's Brewery District, published in Good Beer Hunting. Second place goes to Samer Kaderi for the story With Great Thirst Comes Great Responsibility, Ebenezer's Pub in Lovell, Maine, published in Pellicle Magazine. And first place in best travel writing goes to Bailey Berg for Way Up North, Exploring the Growing Beer Scene in Fairbanks, Alaska, published in Good Beer Hunting. Next, we have the category of best beer and food writing. And here we have an honorable mention for Brandon Kearney for The Great Flemish Stew Debate. What are the hotly contested variations of Belgium's national dish? To find answers to that question and more context to what that means, you can head over to Belgian Smack and read this honorable mention in our beer and food writing category. Third place in beer and food writing goes to David Nielsen for Cacao Brewing and The Price of Nostalgia Toward a Better Future for Chocolate Beer, published in Good Beer Hunting. If you haven't read David's work, which focuses on chocolate and beer and all sorts of things in between, you can find a podcast as well as a lot of other work that David's done in that. This story for Good Beer Hunting and elsewhere. Congrats, David, on the third place finish. Second place goes to Katie Joyce Boulay for These Farmers Want You to Drink Your Hops and Eat Them Too, the first time we've had a piece published in Atlas Obscura, honored for in our award. So congratulations, Katie, on the second place finish. And first place in the category goes to Owen Walsh for Hop Gaster Bar and the Emergence of Bistronomic Beer Cuisine in Leuven, published in Belgian Smock. All right, I'm going to pause again to talk very quickly. Another benefit of the North American Guild of Beer Writers, our mentorship program. If you're not already a member, maybe you want to share your expertise and experience. Maybe you don't have a lot of experience in writing or covering the beer industry and you want to learn more. Well, this year we partnered 60 people for 30 different pairings, each specifically tailored to what a mentor and a mentee either wanted to learn about or wanted to share their experience about. This is just a few areas in which we were able to connect people to learn more about podcasting, vlogging, writing, pitching, pitching books. This is one of the great benefits of the Guild. We have such an array of people, well over 200 active members as part of the Guild from around the world, with lots of different experiences, perspectives, and expertise. And so our mentorship program is just another great way that we work to serve our members and make sure that they can continue to enhance their skills and get better at what they do. If you want to either be a mentor or mentee and you have not yet joined the Guild, nagbw.org/join. You can learn more at reportersnotebook.org. You can always get in contact with us, all of our information on the nagbw.org website, where we push people to join reportersnotebook.org to see all the things that we're up to. All right, we are going to move on with our best business writing category. The honorable mention here goes to Beth Demon for Division in the Ranks, How Should Leadership Organizations Handle Members Breaking the Rules, published in Good Beer Hunting. Next in the best business writing category, third place goes to Kate Bernat for Rebel Without a Cause, Stone Brewing Searches for Identity Amidst Lawsuits, Closures, and Controversies, published in Good Beer Hunting. Congrats, Kate. Second place goes to Josh Noel for Can Shortage Leaves Chicago Brewery Scrambling, Adding Yet Another COVID-19 Hurdle and Spelling the Demise of at Least One Brand, published in the Chicago Tribune. Congrats, Josh. And first place in the best business writing category goes to Mike Kallenberger for The Brand of Craft Beer, Has It Been Diluted? Again, you can find the answer in The New Brewer, published earlier this year. Congrats, Mike, on the first place finish in best business writing. We'll move right along to our best commentary or criticism category. And here we'll start with an honorable mention for Samer Kaderi for Unholy Water, The Middle Eastern Voices Shaping the Global Beer Narrative, published in Good Beer Hunting. Third place in best commentary and criticism goes to Kate Bernat for Great Consequence, Beer Industry Struggles to Define and Deliver Justice for Sexual Harassment Assault Survivors, published in Good Beer Hunting. Second place goes to Alicia Kennedy for Crisis Cava in a Colony and Other Ways of Coping in Old San Juan, published in Good Beer Hunting. And first place for best commentary or criticism goes to Beth Demon for Work, Worth, and Wreckage, When Your Job Is Your Life, What Happens When You Lose It. Congrats, Beth, on your first place finish, best commentary or criticism. We've had a lot going on as we look back at the things that drove those stories and commentary over the last year. And so amongst all the things that I've talked about the Guild has done, we continue to look for ways that we can support our members and others in their learning about the industry and the ways of things that impact it. Earlier this year, we partnered with Dr. J's Crafted for All organization to support Guild members so they could join the Crafted for All Reading Room, a digital book club that was reading and discussing how to be an anti-racist. to better learn ways to cover, understand issues as they relate to diversity, inclusion, and racism, and how people can apply that to their work and how they move through the world. So thank you, Dr. J, for letting us be a part of that. We also have an exciting partnership coming up in which the Guild is going to be partnering with Beer Culture to help support an effort for a editorial support. As Beer Culture relaunches their blog, they will be bringing on a collection of interns to write short profiles and pieces for the Beer Culture blog. And it is a great opportunity to be able to partner and support that effort as we focus on new ways to bring new writers to cover the beer industry. One of the things that we've also done throughout the last year is when we've had the opportunity to support education through reading, we will offer up a discount to help reimburse the price of books for members. These are just a couple of examples. Beer and Racism, and then Tara Nuren's new most recent book, A Woman's Place is in the Brew House. When members purchase these books, we will often have an accompanying video chat, and we happen to have one coming up with Tara just next week. If you are a member, you can buy the book, you can join us for the chat to hear directly from Tara. We will reimburse 50% of the purchase price. You can go to your local bookshop, buy a physical copy from a physical place, support local business. You can find this event and others that we've had on reportersnotebook.org/events. This is just one of the many ways that we work to support our members to keep them learning and doing better at their work. Okay, next category is the best podcast or broadcast category. And in our honorable mention place, we have Will Siss with It Starts With Beer, published on the Hopped Up Network. Congrats, Will. This is a first time being honored for a podcast. Congrats on that. Matthew Curtis earns third place for the Pellicle podcast, published as part of the Pellicle magazine. In second place is Sarah Flora for Brewing After Hours with Sarah Flora, published through the Believe Podcast Network. And first place in the best podcast or broadcast network goes to Brandon Kearney for the Belgian Smack podcast, of course, published through Belgian Smack. Congrats to all of our winners. We have the best beer blog category coming up next. Here we have an honorable mention. Congrats to Oliver Gray. It's been a while since you've been recognized for your blogging work. Oliver is recognized this year for This Must Be the Place, published through Good Beer Hunting. Third place in the category goes to Owen Walsh for Brussels Beer City. And second place in Best Beer Blog is for Beth Demen and the Prohibition newsletter. Congrats to Beth for that. First place in the Best Beer Blog category goes to Jeff Allworth for his blog, Beervana. Congrats, Jeff. And a new category we have this year, Best Brewery Profile. In years past, we found that a lot of these pieces specifically tailored toward highlighting and telling the stories of an individual brewery were put in the same category as our national and international reporting. So we've broken those two off into specific categories as a way to best recognize the vast collection of brewery profiles that get published every year. So this is our new category, and we start out in it with an honorable mention for Emily Monaco for Let Them Drink Bread, Cocomiette in Isère, France, published in Good Beer Hunting. Congratulations to you, Emily. Third place in the category goes to David Nilsson for Tending the Fires, Karen Brewing Company in Dayton, Ohio, published in Good Beer Hunting. Second place for Best Brewery Profile goes to Matthew Curtis for Everything in Its Right Place, the Brewery of St. Mars of the Desert, Sheffield, published in Pellicle Magazine. And first place in Best Brewery Profile goes to Christopher DeWolf for City on Fire, How Young Master Brewery Became the Face of Craft Beer in Restive Hong Kong, published in Good Beer Hunting. Congrats to all of our winners in the inaugural category of Best Brewery Profile. Lastly, before we get into the last collection of award categories, If I haven't given you enough things to think about, the ways that the Guild is staying active, supports members, one of the great things, thank you to Kate Bernat, who helps with compiling pieces for our weekly newsletter. Why is it valuable? Well, in every newsletter, we make sure to offer a variety of things. This is sent directly to our members every week. It includes tips for freelance gigs, job openings. Often we will have insights on professional development opportunities. We will link back to work or video chats that we've had as part of the Guild, so you can go back and watch them. Always watch out for headlines, puns galore there. This is a great way to highlight the work of our members, as well as encourage people every week to seek out, read, listen, understand what's going on in the world of freelancing, media, beer, and beyond. So thank you for everybody who continues to be a member of the Guild. Check out our newsletter every week. If you are not a member and you want to get this and have access to all of the things that I've talked about, nagbw.org/join. All right, we are down to our final two categories. Thank you for everybody for joining throughout. And we will start with best local reporting. One of the things I've loved about this category in recent years is that there has been a steady increase of entries in best local reporting for our awards. And it means a lot understanding that more local reporting is happening in more ways in publications of all sizes. And we will start with third place. Third place in best local reporting goes to Paige Latham Dedora for Business as Unusual, how five Minneapolis and St. Paul bars and restaurants responded to the George Floyd protests. This is published in Good Beer Hunting. Congrats, Paige. Second place goes to Lucy Korn, Hot Farming in the Face of Adversity, Kaya Maloney in Johannesburg, South Africa, published in Good Beer Hunting. And first place in best local reporting goes to Brandon Kearney for Putting Hops on the Table in Belgium's Westhoek, on Leroy Breweries, Popperidge Hop Growers, and the Agricultural Identity of a People, published in Belgian Smile. All right, our final category for today in the 2021 NAGBW Annual Awards, the Best National and International Reporting. And we will start here with an honorable mention for John McMahon for Waiting for a Year of Change, How Thai Brewers Are Fighting Against a Government-Backed Beer Duopoly, published in Good Beer Hunting. Third place in Best National and International Reporting goes to David Jesudison for Desi Style, The History and Significance of England's Anglo-Asian Pubs, published in Pellicle Magazine. Second place in national and international reporting goes to Kate Bernat for Tyranny of the Tickers, How Untapped Ratings Became Craft Beer's Most Fickle Prize, published in Good Beer Hunting. And first place in best national and international reporting goes to Gerard Fagerberg for Waiting on Tides, How Outdated Liquor Laws Trap Craft Breweries Between Regulation and Rebellion, published in Good Beer Hunting. So that's going to be it for awards. Thank you for everybody who's joined.